Good morning, everyone, and happy Friday to everybody. Welcome once again to our Fully Awake 365 devotional. This morning, I am being a peacemaker, LaDonna, because Brandy has been out of town, had a difficult work week this week, and I chose to wear a jacket that is not flawed in any way today.
So it wouldn't
it
get
has an actual zipper that works. Everything's still attached. Although I bet if I like zipped it up weirdly and like did my did like that, that might irritate her a lot right there. All right, let's be nice today. Good to see everybody. Good to see you, my sister. What in the world? The weather has turned a little chilly and you've got a tank top on, LaDonna. What is happening on God's creation?
I put a sweater on and I was walking around getting my lights on and I was too hot.
I just getting too hot. If anybody can relate with this, I was raised as a very sweaty child because my sister was always cold natured. I always had a little bit of sweat on my nose, a little trickle because she was just, oh, it's so chilly. Now she's just hot. But
I still, it goes back and forth now. It swings wildly from one to the other now.
I was forced, and I have forgiven you for this, LaDonna, on long road trips. I was forced to lay in the floorboard of the car so that she could have the entire top. And I was down there with the gravel and the dirt and the
gum
wrappers. What'd you say?
Yes, I did that to you. I'm going to get my karma, I'm sure.
You're going to get that karma. Dr. Sharonda was saying, LaDonna, I know what you mean. I get those swings too.
Yeah.
All right. Well, good morning, everyone. Today is November the 10th. We're going to talk about no small contributions. This is the month of gratitude. And I think somebody might be grateful for my choice of song this morning. I think you'll enjoy this. One of my favorite scenes, one of my favorite comedians is a comedian named Sinbad. You guys remember Sinbad from like the 80s and 90s? Sinbad was in a movie with Phil Hartman, a former comedian on Saturday Night Live. And the movie was called House Guest. And so Sinbad goes out to the suburbs and he's trying to act like he's a dentist and all these things. It's a hilarious movie. But this song plays during one of the parties they have at their house. And Sinbad's dance gives me so much joy. If you have time today, YouTube Sinbad dancing in the movie House Guest. It is just absolutely hilarious. So this is the song that Sinbad was dancing to. It's one of my favorite songs. See if you know the song and the artist. What a win in hand. Ow. I wonder if we counted, LaDonna, how many times in that song they go, ow. Yeah, there's
a
lot.
It will be a lot.
It will be a lot. I like it. All right, let's talk this morning.
All right, let's see. So Ms. Bobby and Dr. Sharonda, I think a lot of us know the name, but Commodores. And there is what is going to be the common mistake on the artist? We all know that. Potentially, you would guess Lionel Richie, and I get that. So I think somebody did, but let's see who got Commodores over on YouTube. Jason, Dr. Ray, Miss Sandra, Mary Hayes, Miss Margie. Oh, Miss Margie said, oops, Commodores. So she got it.
And LaDonna, I don't think that's Lionel Richie singing right there, is it?
It's not. It's the other guy. I don't know what his name is, but yeah.
It's the other guy. Yeah,
it's one of the other guys. They all had, because I know this because I had this poster on my wall of the Commodores around this era. They had these silver glittery rhinestone outfits on.
Yes.
And all of them had the mullet fro. It was a fro, but it was a mullet too somehow. Lionel Richie was best.
High and tight.
Yeah, and then they all switch from the mullet fro to the mullet Jerry curl.
But you know what though, that mullet fro with the kid, the people I was raised with, they called it a ducktail, little ducktail in the back. Yeah.
Yeah, but Lionel Richie had the best one.
80s trivia. By the way, those pants I think were borrowed by Michael Jackson for his Off the Wall video.
Yes, it was same pants, same thing. But that was before Lionel Richie went solo.
My good friend Derek, Onophile Extraordinaire, will introduce.
Okay. Somebody.
I did not know it was still sharing. I'm Googling Sinbad dancing.
All right, we're almost out of time. Look at all this fun we're having today. So we're going to talk today about no small contribution. That was Brick House, the Commodores. And going to turn it over to you, LaDonna.
All right. Our affirmation is, today I will offer help to others and to causes that align with my level of consciousness. I know that my contribution will not change the world by itself. However, it does, and I do make a difference.
No one is too small to make a difference. That is a quote by Greta Thunberg. If you're familiar with her work, she is a very young woman who has taken on the task of promoting environmentalism in different countries all around the world. And she is so committed to her cause that she doesn't fly in airplanes. She doesn't like to use, maybe LaDonna would do this because she doesn't like to fly either, but she basically rides boats. She takes boats across the ocean because she doesn't want to pollute the air anymore. And of course, it's a bit of an extreme, but it's her level of dedication. She also has a touch of autism. She's on the spectrum. And so she is letting her voice be heard even beyond and in spite of any type of challenges that she may have been born with. Some of the things that we face, look at all these big issues that face us, social injustice, the climate crisis, the disparity of wealth, incurable diseases, hunger, and the lack of clean drinking water. There are some really big problems that we face, and sometimes they may seem and feel insurmountable. And if we become hopeless or apathetic, they will continue to be insurmountable. How can we approach them in a healthy way, knowing that we may not change the world ourselves, but we can play our part? We can do something of ourselves. Look at the second paragraph. It says, I heard a beautiful story about a little girl who was walking near the ocean. The sand was covered with thousands of starfish that had beached themselves, and they were dying. She was overwhelmed with compassion and began to throw some of the starfish back into the water. Her father was watching the scene and approached her and said, "Sweetheart, there's no way you can save all of these starfish. There are just too many. I'm not even sure you can make a difference." The little girl then picked up another starfish and threw it back into the water. She looked up at her father and said, "Maybe you're right, but it made a difference for that one." Isn't that just beautiful? Yeah, maybe we can't save everyone, everything. We can't change the world all by ourselves, but we can impact somebody's life. If I can help somebody as I pass along, then my living would not be in vain. Help us, Uncle Harry. Then my living would not be in vain. Yes, we can make a contribution. We can help somebody as we pass along. All right, back to you, LaDonna.
Yeah, just thinking of Uncle Harry, I was driving down North Avenue yesterday and I passed their old house. So rest in peace, Uncle Harry.
Rest in peace. A good man.
We heard him sing that song a lot of times.
Absolutely.
Our ending prayer this morning is, God who can make little much, as I offer my time, talent, and treasure to missions of love and to those in need, use me as a vessel to make a difference somehow, somewhere, for someone. Amen.
Amen. Give somebody some little piece of yourself today, a smile, a friendly gesture, an open door, let somebody in traffic. Yeah, give somebody a little grace that you would like to receive. There's some small way that you can impact somebody's life today, maybe just an empathetic, active, listening ear. Be the change that you desire to see in the world by just practicing the religion of kindness. Thank you, Mahatma. The Mahatma Gandhi gave us that beautiful idea. And the Dalai Lama also gives us gives us that. All right. So Sunday, I am going to talk, we're going to talk about using the name of God in vain. I am really excited about this teaching. I think we're going to unpack it together, LaDonna. You like that teaching phrase?
Yeah.
So looking forward to spending some time with you on Sunday. My sister is in demand. She is traveling, doing a little speaking on Sunday for my cousin, Bishop Jim Swilly at the Metron community. And so wishing her, sending her good vibes. I know it'll be a good time as well, but we'll miss you on Sunday. We'll see you either virtually Sunday morning, 10 a.m. or in person. Have a great day. Go in peace.